Hi there, sign of Scorpio. This is Kim, here to do your next 48-hour reading. And this reading is going to be channeled for you from your spirit team, from your angels. My spirit team helps too. And I like to be as open as I can, letting myself step to the side so that only messages for your highest good are the ones that are coming in. Scorpio, using the Modern Love Tarot deck, and I have the Kipper deck fortune cards just in case. All right, so channeled just means that any messages can come in, and I'm specifically reaching out to your spirit team, your angels, for assistance. That's what that means to me. The Devil here on the bottom of the deck, which is the underlying issue, might be about some kind of greed or materialism, maybe we could also go the good route with that card and say it's about planning and all earthly material matters. Maybe you're working on your physique too, with that person right up here working out weight. Brave, confident, looks good because of the work they've put into. See, this is what everybody's dealing with right now. The Five of Pentacles, it's here right now for you. Yay. But, you got the Five of Cups, too. The good thing is that we're moving past that. Wow, and yes, the Wheel of Fortune's here for you, too, for the outcome. So, we have somebody, okay, either somebody's going to extend their hand to you, offer to help with something, or something's going to make the load lighter. Careful what we're attached to, and careful about overconsumption or overdoing it, drugs, alcohol, things like that. So, because that can represent our addictions or vices that possibly are contributing to this crisis of what we're going through with this Five of Pentacles. Right now could feel like a crisis, but it only feels like this as we power through those emotions. With the Five of Cups, you're definitely like getting through a temporary phase, but it's very emotional and it's tangible. It's expressing itself in many different ways to you now. It is the contrast. If you have another five, I just noticed that the Five of Wands is in reverse. 555, huge changes. Likely you will be at crossroads where you just have a choice. And when you get to this crossroads, you move right past this five energy, but it can feel pretty stormy in this five energy too. So justice in reverse is the heart of the matter underneath the Hierophant. Okay, but first let me go ahead and go to the next five. I think it's almost important to look at the 555 first that's happening, because this is involving from the past, the Five of Wands in the reverse. No more games, silliness, competition, none of that. Now, why? I don't know. Was there a split? Was there ultimately having to get away from each other? I'm not really sure, but action was taken so as not to argue so much about whatever this is. The Five of Cups is still holding on to some kind of sadness here. And then the Five of Pentacles, like I said, it's a tangible thing, but it could be feeling left out, like in a relationship, feeling left out, or financial worry or strain or stress, having confidence in our commitment. Having confidence in our commitment is the challenge, but you have strength, and the card that is representing you, Scorpio, is the Lover's card. So you are at this crossroads. It's a crossroads between yourself. I think some of you are doing really, really good transformations too. Really beautiful, wonderful transformations. And it's boosting the confidence. It's boosting self-esteem. And it's providing that path to be lit up for you to get out of these fives. You will have confidence in a commitment. I don't know what commitment this is, because of course it's going to be different for people, but you will have reasons to be very confident regarding a commitment. And especially when you're like, okay, well, something is, I'm going to get my justice. Like, karma will get that person. I'm not worrying about that. So whatever's off balance, you do get your burdens relieved. This is looking like a, you know, a stack of things needing to be weighed, put down, reprioritized, lifting your burdens. Somebody's wanting to help you, to extend a help or extend a hand to help you. Some of you all, I could be communicating with a passed on loved one with this judgment energy, especially with the way that it is, with the hand reaching. Maybe this is about forgiveness in your spirituality, forgiveness being part of a challenge for a commitment. And so second chances can come with that. I don't know, guys. I mean, you're feeling like whatever this crossroads is about, that you're going to make the right decision and that you're with the person that you feel is this soul connection. You're ready to release this stuff. You just need the confidence to release it and to forgive, right? Okay, so it's a test of forgiveness, in a sense, if you want to word it a test. Forgiveness is healing to everybody involved. So it's not necessarily a test as much as it is something that would be wise to do to feel better in your own skin, in your own soul even. So just kind of be on the watch out for anything to do with temptation right now, or materialism, greed, attachments to things that, well, you know what I mean? It's false attachment. It's attachment to things that we don't get to take with us when we go, so to speak. The signs that I can have Taurus, Libra, Gemini, Leo. The Wheel of Fortune, the good luck card is Aquarius, Scorpio, Taurus, or Leo. And this is the death and rebirth cycle. You're thinking about this and you're bringing in your own good luck. I don't know why there's something going off on that. But anyway, I will have to take care of that. That is your reading for this part. Thank you so much. Send you light and love.